Hi everyone. It's a sad day today in Manchester. There's been a lot going on with the bombings. It's just so very sad. I live a mile away from where it happened. We've had police up and down the streets, the helicopters out, ambulances up and down. It's a very scary thought, and it's very scary that people can do things like this and think that it's acceptable. People who are not right in their minds. It's just so sad. And stuff like this never needs to happen. We should never want to hurt another person. We should never even think about it. Like, why would you even think about doing stuff like this? But if they want to break us, Manchester's the wrong place to do it. The IRA tried. The people with all the major riots a few years ago, they tried, and now this. You can't just. Manchester's just too strong. Like, we all stick together. Taxi drivers last night turned all the meters off, and they were driving people as far as Liverpool and Newcastle just to make sure that they got home safe and for free. Nurses, doctors, they've come in. Voluntarily helping out the staff in the hospitals, so have police. A lot of takeouts, they're giving out free food and shelter. A lot of churches and mosques have opened the doors and let people come and stay. A lot of people have opened up the houses and said, "Look, we've got spare rooms, come and stay." Sorry, it's a sad day today. And my mum was working there last night, and luckily she called me this morning and told me that she was safe. She left a bit before it happened. But it could have all been so different. It's just very close to home, and no matter where in the world you live, this sort of thing should not be happening anywhere. So, I just want to say thank you to all the medical staff, the police, and everyone who's helped everyone out, because it's been amazing. Like today, fear, it brings out the worst in people, but it also brings out the best. And you get to see how great people are, how loving and caring people are, and how kind people are. And it doesn't matter about religion or colour of your skin or where you're from. When something happens, you stick together and you fight the good fight. We're all Mancunians. Wherever you're from, you're all part of the same people. We all have to live on this world together. So just be good to each other. And that goes for all of us. If you see someone today who needs help, give them help. If you see a homeless person on the street, go in the nearest shop and buy a drink. Give them a smile. Say hello. Do something nice for someone else today. Because if more people did nice things for each other, there'd be less of this bull going around. People in the world need to sort themselves out, honestly. And that's that for me. That's my rant over. And I also want to say thank you to everyone who's messaged me. I've had so many messages today just checking that me and my boys are okay. And we are, thank you. My mum's okay, a little bit shaken up, but she's fine. My brother was in town today, and he's fine. Because where he works, he works in the Arndale. And he went to make sure that all his workmates were all right when it was evacuated. And we're all fine. Just a bit stressed out that it's happened. But so many people have messaged, and if more people was like us crafters, if more people thought of others rather than themselves and what they believe is right or what they want to do. You just thought of others, then maybe this kind of thing wouldn't happen. Right, I'm gonna move on to something else because I'm getting myself all worked up. I've been upset throughout the day. But I think also when you live this close and you're seeing it all happen, you saw it all happen last night. And you can see the MEN out of my window. That's how close I am to it. And when you're seeing it all happen in front of you, it really brings home, you know? It really, I don't know, you just end up in shock. And today's just been a day where you just don't really know what to do. There's a vigil out in town tonight, starting at 6. Well, it's already gone that now, but I was gonna go, but I can't get a babysitter. And in case something else happens tonight, my kids are too young at 3 and 4, I don't want to take them to something like that just in case. Right. I did finish some things. Seems a bit bad going into that talk, but from that subject into this one. But I mainly filmed just to say thank you to everyone, in one fell swoop. I've been privately messaging others back, but I've just thought, you know, like you see my face, you can see that we're okay. So yeah, I kind of feel bad going from that into my crafty stuff. But I'm a Mancunian, you get up, you dust your shoes off, and get on with the day, don't you? I think British stiff upper lip, that one, innit? Right, so I'm not sure if you've seen this before. This was done in Pound Stretcher Glitz and Glam Double Knitting. So it's the 200 gram ball. I used two of them, so it's rather big. It's all glittery with the stellina in it. So it is 97% acrylic, 30% Lorex. So it's just the granny shawl. I've got a residential home opposite, well, on the same main road as I'm on. So, because I've been really into my granny shawls at the minute, I might go see if they'll take some. Just pop them over and see if any of the residents want them. Might as well, eh? Can't keep everything I make. Although I have put some stuff up on my Etsy shop. So I'll try and post the link under it. They also did this virus shawl. From Ice Yarns. So it's in the Magic Light in the greys and whites. 100% acrylic. She DK weight for the 100 grams. So that's the virus shawl. I've not blocked it. And I hope you can hear me all right. I think I've been having some problems with the sound on the last two videos. And I'm not actually sure. Well, the last video, I had the camera on my bed, so I don't know if it was like the bed linen was muffling the mic. Or whether it's because I use this phone for practically everything in my life and it's almost a year old. Maybe it's just conking out a bit. And I did finish these. Now, I usually knit my needles. I usually knit my socks on 2.25 millimeter needles. Now let me show you this. Same amount of stitches, just the leg has just the leg has 10 rows less in this pair. Let me show you the difference in size. It's a massive difference in that, isn't there? Because this is a bit too big for my blocker, and that one's just perfect. So I think maybe I need to go when I'm using Cascade Heritage, because the yarn's so soft and just smooth and it glides. I knit a lot looser, and I've got a loose tension anyway. So I think I need to go to a 2 millimeter. But they're good though. They're like be nice and comfy to wear over your leggings. You know, just like the ruffly socks. So I'm happy with them anyway. So that was Cascade Heritage solids, a 4-ply fingering in I think the colour was anise, and that's my haul. So I've done that one. I'm not sure if the pattern for this is on Ravelry. I keep looking, but I'm not seeing it. But it's that simple. It's gotta be on there somewhere. So I'll keep on looking, and if not, I'll write it up. But it's gotta be on there somewhere. I just need to hold out a bit longer and keep searching. There's just so many patterns on there, and then you've got to click into each one and enlarge the picture, and bit of a nightmare. So anyway, that one, and I'm almost on the heel. But I did do, I've just not sewn in the ends, I blocked it. But I finished off my Girl from the Grocery Store by Kohi Locatella. Now I did like working it. I just got to the lace bit at the bottom. And for some reason, I had the wrong amount of stitches and I muddled it up. So I'll see there how them eyelets don't line up with that one. So anyway, I didn't want to go through all the rest of it, so I just bound it off. And I'm just calling it a job done. But it's pretty nice. I'm sure I'd work it again. It's very long. But yeah. I'm no good at placing shawls on there. No good at all. Look like a bib. I'll take my bib off now. I cannot dress them up or anything. I'll leave that to better shawl people than me. I did buy some new patterns. I bought, oh, what's she called? She does a lot of tops in sport weight. Oh, blimey. Andrea, Ma no, not Andrea Mowley, is it? Anyway, I bought one of the tops that she made. She does a lot of the comfy, loose kind of sport weight jumpers. She's pretty popular. I'm sure her name begins with an A. I should go into my computer and look it up, but it's propping up my phone at the minute. I've lost the stand. But I'll show you next time anyway. Ooh. I'm cramping. Oh. Right, I'm back. It's gone. Yeah, I'll show you next time because I have got dun dun dun. My printer's coming tomorrow morning. Dead excited. And she's getting message after message. I forgot to put airplane mode on my phone. Ooh, back again. I've drank a lot of Coke today. I might need to trump later. And yes, I am very unladylike. You won't catch me with airs and graces. But I need to go, I go. Anyway, I think that's it. I think that's all of it. Don't have any new stuff other than new patterns because I'm on my yarn. But I finished. Should stop filming, really, shouldn't I? But I'm almost done now, so I'm sure you can hack it a bit longer. So I finished about five projects, so I might be around about 800 grams into my challenge. I just need to sew all the ends in, weigh everything, and then I've done a spreadsheet. I've got Microsoft Office. So yeah, I just need to fill it in the spreadsheet, and I'm gonna keep a running tally. And yes. Still not bought any wool. It has been a week since my last shop buy. I feel like I do need a confessional sometimes when it comes to buying yarn. But you know what? I'm doing well. The only thing is, though, the money that I usually spend on wool is just sat there in my account, and I'm like, oh, I'm not used to having this much. I feel a bit rich. What can I buy? So next week, my kids' carpets are coming because I had to buy carpets. You know what? It's amazing when you're not buying wool how much other stuff you can actually buy. I just bought my printer, carpets. I'm gonna get a wardrobe in the next couple of weeks, a big free door one from Victoria Plum. It's smashing, isn't it? Might just stick with this band forever or until I run out of wool. I'm not that daft. I can't do that. Kill me now. Well, not really. I like to craft more first. Anyway, that's it from me. Yeah, like I said, just go out, do something nice for someone today, smile at someone, say hello. Yeah, see a homeless person, go in the shop, buy them a meal, bring it out to them. You don't have to give them money if you think it's going to be spent on something like drugs or alcohol. Don't do that, just buy them a meal. I'm sure they'd more than appreciate it. Give some of your crafts to people who need it. Send some to charities, to old folks' homes. You know, just do something for someone else. I think today is one of them days where it makes you realise that we should all love and care for one another. And not just in the tough times like this, it should be every day. All the time, and this is just a reminder, and I'm telling myself as well, not just all of you. We just all need to go out there and spread the love, basically. Go and spread the love. And I want all of you, no matter where you are in the world, to stay safe, stay strong, and just take care of yourselves. Just look after yourselves, look after your loved ones. And branch out from there to looking after everyone else. And that's it. Thanks for me. From me, for me. Thanks from me. I think I need some sleep. Goodbye, everyone.